Hi, and welcome to this quick tutorial on how to import MPFB characters into Unity. One of the most common questions asked in comments on MPFB2 YouTube videos is why materials look so strange in Unity after export. Preparing for and exporting to Unity isn't actually all that complicated, but there are a few key settings and operations that are needed. If you are not aware of these, things will end up being rather cumbersome. In this video, I will cover what is needed. Before demonstrating the procedure in practice, I will provide a quick summary of what is needed. If you know your way around MPFB and Unity, this is likely all that you need in order to do a successful import. However, I will then also demonstrate the relevant steps that are needed. Before continuing this video, it is also worth mentioning that this is not intended for beginners. It is expected that you already understand Blender and Unity, and that you have at least played around with MPFB. If this is your first encounter with MPFB, I recommend that you begin with watching the Getting Started with MPFB YouTube video before continuing. Anyway, for a quick summary. Most problems with importing to Unity stem from a confusion about what a material is, and missing the annoying fact that Blender procedural materials simply have no corresponding version in Unity. When exporting to Unity, you should therefore only use simple materials, which are a combination of a diffuse texture and possibly a normal map. To achieve this, you should disable both procedural eyes and procedural skin before applying skin and eyes to your character. Then it might make sense to remove things which are there to support character modeling in Blender. While strictly speaking not necessarily a problem, the helper geometry and the target shape keys might get in the way further down the road in Unity. Since they most likely have no use there, we might as well remove them. After having exported the character to FBX, there are also a few minor operations that are needed before lifting the character into the scene. We need to mark the materials as having an alpha channel, and we will want to set up the humanoid rig bone matching. But let's start with setting up a character. Before doing anything else, I would suggest configuring the appropriate skin and eye settings in the library settings panel. As said, you will want to disable all procedural aspects of skin and eyes. Thus, we will set the skin to skin model 0 and uncheck the procedural eyes checkbox. We also have no need for material instancing. Now we can quickly create a basic character. Note here that we will want to use the game engine rig, as it has 100% bone mapping to mechanism, which will make it work seamlessly with the animations in Unity. In regards to eyes, you might want to use low poly eyes here. The difference is that low poly eyes have no outer transparent layer. Unless you need or want such a layer, it will probably only be in the way. Let's just pick a bunch of system assets for the rest of the character. In the real world, you will probably want something less boring from the asset packs. Now we have a finished character. If you feel certain that you are done modeling, you can now remove the supporting structures, which are only there for MPFB functionality. For example, you can see that there is a hidden helper mesh, which is there for clothes fitting, and which does not make much sense in Unity. The shape keys are probably not something you need either, but there might be advanced scenarios where they might make sense in Unity. Anyway, for both, we can easily remove them on the operations panel. The order is important here. First remove the helpers and then bake the shape keys. Now we can make an FBX export. Make sure only the character is selected. In the export panel, specify that only the selected objects should be exported. It is also important that you set path mode to copy so the textures are included in the export. We'll save the FBX file directly in the appropriate subdirectory of our Unity project. In Unity, we will now discover that there is a new file in the assets directory. Before continuing, I'd like to mention that it was years and years since I worked with Unity professionally. It is very possible that there are more efficient ways to perform the operations outlined here. So bear with me and listen with the attitude that you can probably figure out how to do these things better than me. Anyway, the first thing we should do before dragging the asset into our scene is open the properties panel for our export. Select the file and click Alt-P. To get control over the materials, we will want to extract them from the FBX. As you can see, they have now ended up in our assets. We will now open each of these materials and assign the proper texture. I will select the files in order and click Alt-P to open their properties. For items such as eyelashes and eyebrows, it is important to specify that the material is transparent. With the materials in order, we will want to set up rigging too. So we open up the rigging tab and specify that the rig is humanoid and apply. If Unity likes it, you should get a check mark. Otherwise, I guess it will say something impolite or curse at you or something. An avatar should appear in the asset list. We can Alt-P and configure avatar on this. In all likelihood, everything should be possible to leave at their defaults. But we can switch to the Muscles and Settings tab to make sure that the bone mapping is functional. Now we can drag the character into the scene. Looks like it works decently. Let's demonstrate how it would look if we forgot to configure transparency on the eyebrows. So if you get something that looks opaque and clunky, check that the transparency is correctly configured. Anyway, that's it for today. Thank you for watching and happy modeling.